Ever wondered whether you could make it through the day? I mean, sometimes you wake up in the morning and you say, oh my God, there is so much to do today. I don't know how I will handle it. Or you're faced with a big issue with age maybe, you're older, or with financial pressure or relational pressure, and you wonder how you are going to make it. You know, there is a Bible verse that is great motivator and encouragement. I want to read it. It's in Deuteronomy chapter 33, verse 25b. It says here, and as your days, so shall your strength be. As your days, so shall your strength be. Now, in the way it appears in English, it means, you know, it doesn't matter what comes your way, you're going to have strength to face the issues, to face the problems, to resolve it in a positive way. It doesn't matter what comes your way, whether it is age, whether it is whatever pressure comes your way. God will give you the favor the very moment when you wake up. He's given you enough energy, He's given you enough wisdom to handle the day, to face the issues. If God intended you to have more power, more strength, He would have given you more. But since He gave you this much as you got, that's exactly enough to face the issues of the day. This word in Hebrew, dobe, is really the only word that appears here in the Bible. And scholars have had difficulties understanding what it really means. In the Septuagint, in the Greek translation of the Hebrew Bible, it's translated as Isis. And it comes from the Arabic root, which means rest or quiet. At that time, the Israelites were faced with Phoenicians' army and as an enemy. And God says, I'm going to give you rest. Whoever attacks you, I'm going to be there to defend you. I'm going to help you out to defend yourself and to not fail, to not lose, to not become a slave, in other words, to those attacks, to not become a victim. God says, I'm going to be there, I'm going to give you rest, I'm going to give you peace. Actually, in Isaiah 26:3, it says, He keeps those in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on Thee. In other words, when you and I focus our attention in whatever circumstance of our lives, whatever issue we face, we focus our attention on what God says about that situation, then we have the positive results. If there is sickness coming to you, you say, God says, I am healed by His stripes. If poverty comes to you, you say, I'm rich through Christ. He has come to bring me fullness of life. You know, Word of God is great motivator, great inspiration, great encouragement. So let's go to the Word of God. Actually, the Arabic word is derived from dabi, which means abound in riches. And then it would mean the older you get, the richer you become. In other words, you are increasing continuously, like the Psalm says. God wants you and your children to increase more and more. So it's so important to know that when you wake up, when you're faced with an issue, God is right there and He's given you, inside of you, all the energy, all the strength, all the power that you need to face the issues. God has already enabled you. Often we look for solutions somewhere else. If just my dad could help me, or if my brother could help me, or if my pastor could help me, or my boss could give me, or if the government would. You know, we always look for solutions, often somewhere outside of us, and yet the solutions are within us. God placed the strength. God placed the power. God placed the ability within you to resolve whatever you face. So take the Word of God, plant the Word of God inside of you. Let it inspire you, let it motivate you, and let it show you how you can reach much further with Him. Because Paul says, you know, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. When I say, or you say, I can do all things means there is nothing that you and I cannot do. So God has given you the ability. What you and I need to do is to employ it, use it, and God will give us a favorable result.